Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. My name is D-Free, and for today's video, we're going to be using the new Zenkai 7 Goku on a Sun Family team. So Sun Family is a team that's kind of interesting because of the fact that, you know, they have really solid options across the board, obviously. And when it comes to this yellow Goku, the immediate competition that you would have in mind would be a character like Future Gohan, who, especially at high stars, is not only one of the most annoying characters in the game, especially if he's built with defensive equips, he's a very powerful character overall, despite being, at this point, pretty old. So really, I'm going to pose a question to you guys. What do you guys think about this Goku as an option for this team instead of Future Gohan? Do you like the utility of the endurance, or would you rather have this Goku's ability to sub in whenever you want? As you guys see the video, I'll point this out multiple times. I've already played my matches, of course, and by this point I've probably played something like 30 matches maybe or something like that with this Goku, so I actually really like him a lot and the way that they changed him. But this ability stands to be incredible. So you have the ability that a character like Robbery has, where you can sub into a rush, you'll see that, but also when they do things like blue cards, this is pretty crazy, because if you have five counts or less, obviously, because he needs to be subbing in, it'll reduce a certain, it'll shorten sub count by five. So if you have a character that's about to get KO'd by a blue card, an ultimate, awakened arts, whatever the case is, although awakened arts typically don't kill by meta units anyway. Anyways, long story short, he can save them from dying, right? And you can throw him out there, and two things happen when he actually dies. He offers all of these buffs, health, damage, key recovery, and ultimate slash awakened arts damage. Yeah, that's pretty crazy for a character like Gohan, who is a last man standing character that has progressive damage in the form of like blast cards and stuff like that. And is still obviously a powerhouse, one of the top five characters in the game still at this point, in my opinion. Crazy for him to get all that stuff, and also other characters like SS3. And not only that, he also can get this here, which is debuffs to the enemy, reducing their key recovery, sustained damage cut effects to allies, and these are all non-cancelable things, right? So he's a character, he also has this here where he shortens ally sub count, which is incredibly good. Also has this here, which is some more key reduction. He's a character that's very well-rounded, very good, and I like him a lot. I really do. I think he's a very well-designed character. And he might wind up being the best yellow on at least a couple of his teams that are available to him. So I'm asking you guys how you feel about him on Sun Family. Because again, Sun Family has a lot of different options. But this is the team that I'm using. I don't plan on using the purple or blue characters here. The red Goku is only there for... because they're all Gokus. I can put this Gohan in the leader spot and give him HP. I don't plan on using the Namek Goku, even though he could be a character that benefits as another last man standing type of character. I could use Goku and Vegeta, but I really probably won't. Even though, again, they're really good with that Goku as well, I probably won't use them just because they'll probably steal the show. Last thing I'll say is, when it comes to this guy, do consider that you do want to try to keep him on a team with as many Saiyans as possible because of this unique ability in particular. So that's part of why, that's part of the way that they kind of limited the utility of Sun Family and stuff like that. But really what we have is, we have the Goku who will offer those defeated buffs. We have Gohan's in-battle passive ability to increase blast damage and stuff like that. And we'll have a lot going on. So there are going to be times where we just can explode for damage. So there's going to be matches where Goku stays around, because I think Goku is not, hear me, is not a character you want to just throw out there the first chance you get to get him killed to get the defeated buffs. He is better than that. He should stay alive as long as possible. And really, if we're being completely honest, I think the best way to play this guy is to spam switch him in and then switch him out. You can even, I'll point this out in matches, you can even try to bait rising rushes with him by people that don't know his kit. But you really want to throw him in, let him take a blue card or something. He has draw speed, so he can stall. He has key, all that stuff, so he can stall, get you some Dragon Balls or whatever, then switch him out. And then whenever you need to, as long as it's not off combo or some weird way of landing a rush, like a single tap, you know, whatever. If it's in combo, you can throw him out there. So that's the best way, in my opinion, to use him. And I think he can hang. So, long intro. I really like this character a lot. So, anyways, here we go with match one. All right, here's the first match. And it is versus a future type team. Wish I did the green with this guy, to be honest. Not Gohan. But it's all right. I'll take that. Surprised. He sure was playing me for that. GG on that one. He finally got me. Thank you. What about here? He's certainly dropping. Or subbing here, excuse me. Trunks. Yeah, he had no choice that time. He played me for those drop combos earlier. And they worked out in his favor, although he didn't get the final, you know, outcome. But he had no choice but to sub there. At least I feel that. That's fine. Do not mind that. Great patience, my man. I'll go to Gohan here. Oh, okay. I'll tackle. Ah, Vegeta was in. Okay. I'm so used to Goku being there because Goku's actually there a lot of the time, right? At least half, more than half the time, because you lead with him. So the only thing I need to worry about is when it comes to a rush, having it activate on my terms. Meaning that, like, if they're going to rush my Gohan or the other Goku, I can't have it be outside of, like, a combo like this. I can't have it be, like, on an off play, like a drop combo or something weird like that, right? It just has to happen as part of a combo. There's that. Because of the fact that I won't be able to throw this Goku out there. I'll rescue here. I'm going to pull the ult here. Sorry, Trunks. Nice try. Goodbye, Gohan. That's a nice trade-off, right? My, what's it called? Cover for the Gohan Endurance? And before I don't get it. Okay. I would have been actually really upset if I didn't get it. Like, right there, if he would have rushed, I would have been upset. Might have worked out, but I would have been upset regardless. Here's the point. Can't blast there because I don't want it to be an off-combo situation like I was talking about. Ooh, I think I might have got that one if I didn't, like, drag my finger. I think I drug my finger a little bit. I'll set up here. And this is fine because Goku will come back in for the rush that's happening right here. Didn't I just call it? That was literal just bait to throw Goku out there. And that is the utility this Goku has. I swapped there. Wow, and I didn't die. Nice. I swapped there just for bait, ironically. That's gonna hit. Ooh, he swapped just in time. Oh my god. He swapped just in time. That right there. And that activates, not to the same degree, not 10 counts, but it also activates on blue cards and awakened cards and stuff. That utility right there is crazy, and it can be cheesed very well. Like I said, that was one of the main ways I like using this character. I swapped just to have that happen. GG, bro. Did he just restore gauge? Oh, it's a blue. But you shouldn't have enough. That's not a full gauge restore. Yeah, okay. GG. He swapped to get HP there, by the way. Let's see if he lives it. He did live it. Not bad. I didn't think he would. Okay, GG now. The swap gave him just enough, I imagine. Let's go home. We're just going to not do it in the first place. So I was okay with Goku dying there, but I really wanted to show how broken that ability is. And I'm not trying to make it sound like I'm some, you know, like pro play, this or that. I just really like the idea that you can throw out there whoever you want and then set your opponent up if they don't know the kit of the Goku anyway. He's brand new, so obviously some people just don't know it right now. You can set them up to say, okay, I'm going to take this rush. And he's not the only character that can do that. There's characters like Robbery, for example, or Trunks. Like, there are characters that can do that. But his combination where you could do the same on, like, blue cards or whatever, he's the only one like that. So it's crazy. Obviously, again, blue cards are not as flexible because it's half the counts. But, yeah, it's crazy you can do that, man. Okay, we have a match versus the Fusions team. Not what I expected, but okay. Use the green, please. Use your green, damn it! No? Okay, you're just going to try to use a blue? Do you have the last card you need? I didn't think so, because you started the combo with someone else. Now you have it. Okay. Thought about throwing Gohan into that, if I'm being honest, because Goku would have come back with 5 counts. But that probably would have been a little too edgy. You gonna cancel me? No, you're gonna try to wait it out, I guess, huh? And go for your blue. Oh, okay, that's fine. I got a couple Dragon Balls, not mad. Thanks for that. There you are. Okay, let's go for the blue here. Blast, strike, blast, and... Damn it. Of course! Bye, Vegito. I'll go for a tackle here. Okay, let's back out. Maybe I'll get a green card play. Ah, you suck for that. Okay, that's the best thing he could have ever done. So let's see if he gets it. Oh, nice. Touche, bro. He was neutral, so he would have done a ton of damage. Okay, so for this one, it's tricky to do, but I think what I'll do is I'll try to save my ultimates till after Goku is defeated. Don't hold me to it. It's very tricky to do because there's value in pulling it earlier, like the chance to kill a character or blast armor. I'll try. Like Broly on a fusion team? Did I see that right? Ah, great. Is that what this is? Lag is what it is. Oh, I wish I knew he was gonna drop combo with sub to Green Goku. He dropped thinking I would save with Green Goku. But the switch buff for Broly is too powerful. I don't even know how many stars that Broly had. Honestly, I just was. Ooh, I'll cover here. Honestly, I just was focused on what I was trying to tell you guys. I didn't swipe there. Getting destroyed, by the way. It's gonna bring Goku in. Which is two switch buffs, by the way. Broly is a real menace when he starts getting all the switch buffs. Thankfully he didn't land that. Okay. What? Okay, I'm pissed. Thank you. If only I didn't miss two of those dash forwards, by the way. I missed two of those. Missed one earlier, and I missed one just now. You know, ironically, I wound up waiting until the ult was available after a Goku defeat. 70 million damage. Good lord. Chill! God damn! That wasn't even a crit in that combo. 7 million damage combo that we just unleashed. 7.7. No rush either. God damn. Holy moly. I was getting absolutely wrecked, so I'm very happy this is starting to turn in my favor, because my god, this one was pissing me off. It's fine. Alright. Goodness, man. Did I wind up using SS3's ult? I honestly don't know. I blacked out. I don't know, bro. Wow. So a low amount of GGs here, but I'll tell you that ever since Legends Festival, I've encountered a number of players that have low GGs but are really, really good, and I'm thinking it's because of rerolls. Let me know if you rerolled the game. Anyways, here we go. Also, by the way, there are no longer any bots in PvP, at least upwards of rank 50. So keep that in mind. Unless they DC mid-match, right? And then the bot takes over. Oh, that was supposed to be a tap shot, but he got a little closer than I intended there. That's fine. Did you think I was going to cover or something? Man, this is a fine matchup. I need you to go to Gogeta before I even consider doing anything. Oh, a green. Good play. I should have threw my green Goku out there. That would have been a chance to utilize his cover without using his cover. It's a very underrated way of using those special covers that he has. Is you could take advantage of this character's like Gogeta Blue or whatever that can nullify it, and then you have it for later. Full screen strike. Ooh. Nice drift. See, that's what I'm talking about. That was a high-level play right there. It was subtle, but it was a very high-level play. You know, I'll go for it, just to get it out the way early. I don't mind Oob. Yeah, I didn't mind that. So if I can get Oob's endurance early, that's a win. So I'll go for it. Nice. Yeah, just, and also, sometimes I fall victim to holding my rush for like 3 or 4 minutes, and the opponent's already used theirs, and they're building up midway through a second one, and it just comes back to bite you in the butt. Should've threw my ult there. It just comes back to bite you in the butt. Oh, I didn't expect a switch, otherwise I would have went for a single. Nice. Use a green. Use a green. Actually, I throw Gohan in, I think. Oh my god, that's very bad. Okay, that's fine. Because I clicked Gohan really prematurely. Like, if he had threw a rush there, Gohan would have got rushed. That's how you don't want to have that happen. Rush here. I'm stupid. I knew it. I knew it was going to happen. I knew it was going to happen. I was playing with fire there. I knew it was going to happen. Maybe I guessed, though. I do. Okay. Lucky, lucky, lucky. Let's get him out of here. See, some high-level plays from him. Not bad. He's definitely not bad at this game. Probably did reroll, like I was saying. Should have charged or something. Thought I'd get enough key. Gotcha. And goodbye. Ah! I had that one, but I was too dead set on creating distance to use my green there. He's neutral here, for what that's worth. Since he already threw his rush, though, to be honest, I'll throw Gohan in here. Draw your ult. Use it, please. Oh, blue, huh? Okay. That's fine as well. Ha! He didn't even die again. Twice in this video, he didn't die. That is legendary. I should have striked there. That's legendary, dude. Don't see this. He sees this. I'm too swipe happy. This match is one that I am certainly selling. Let's see if we can salvage it. I mean, it's definitely doable. I have type advantage. I have my ult still. Like, this is certainly doable. Okay, well, I got the vantage, so all I really need to do is just throw a blue, assuming he doesn't end up mid-range, which I'll have to use a strike. If he goes for that, that'll for sure reset us. He's healing a lot. Okay, he's at a million HP almost, give or take. The damage buff, the switch buff, all that should amount to blue killing him here. Yep. GG. Nice try. He's neutral, by the way. So it may not be over. I'll have to go the full distance. Yeah, I got him. GG, man. That was a good game. Like I said, don't... Oh, come on. Don't don't underestimate players right now. Don't do it. That match, I made a few mistakes toward the middle of the match. And I got bailed out on that rush guess as well. That was a good game. Dude, I picked up my PlayStation controller and was about to play the game with that. Not that I could, but could you imagine? All right. He's just looking for a perfect guy, see? Nice, okay, that's fair. Crit on the first hit, beautiful. Couple of hits already. Gogeta, how many cards do you have? You have draw speeds of probably 3 cards total. 2. Last one? Okay. Thanks for the freaking blast seal. That is so annoying. I forgot all about the blast seal. The blast seal ruined my entire chain because I was going to click that stupid blast, not the strike. And by the time I realized, I tried to wait it out and I, you know, basically didn't have it. I went too late. I didn't have enough time to do what I wanted to do. Stupid blast seal. Yeah, see, that's what he wants. He's just going to look for those off. Yeah. Okay. I think I'm going to throw Gohan into Beta Rush. Glad I didn't yet. I was about to. That's the part where it's really tricky is when do you do it? You got to make sure it's not into a rush. Okay, I'll take it. I thought about rushing there, but let's see how strong this ult is. Okay. Should have rushed. Okay. Good to know. Wow, this is about 50%. Not anywhere near enough damage. Gotcha. Bye-bye. No bye-bye. Wow, he's tanking pretty well, isn't he? I did all that just to still wind up pulling the rush. Talk about a waste of resources. Next time I'm in that scenario, I'll just freaking waste to be fair, it was a waste either way. I'll just do the rush. I don't know. I feel like the neutrality was needed, otherwise I wouldn't have killed him with just the rush outside of pulling my name. Okay, that's fine. At least it's not the other one. That's my response when I get hit with that. With this guy, it's good. Don't get me wrong. It's just like, at least it's not the other one, right? That's fine. Go for it. I don't care. I really don't care. Because he's going to either stay or he's going to be forced to switch. He's lost the vanish. He's used the greens. He won't have it. He'll have to sub to Bardock. There it is. Like I said. Like clockwork. You can't. No blast armor. Okay. Okay. Never mind. Whatever. Okay, I'll just say it. I asked the game to do a dash forward tap punch. Not to say that I would have got the priority, but the game didn't even attempt to do it. It just did a full-on tap. Wow, nice try, bro. GG. GG. Yeah. Nice try, man. I'm gonna leave it there. Because when it starts getting like that, I start getting a little frustrated. I'm done. All right, peace.